Hi, this is Daniel from the Ultimate Guitar Academy, and I'm going to show you how to play the D minor chord. Remember that minor chords have to state that they are minor, either by the word minor or by a lowercase m next to the capital letter of the chord. Without that, it would actually mean a major chord, which is completely different. So to play the D minor chord, I'm going to take my index finger and put it first fret on the high E string. This will be my anchor point. An anchor point is simply a point of reference that we remember, allowing us to find the chord quickly from that location. This results in fast learning of chords as well as fast chord changing. From my anchor point, I want to reach out to third fret on the B string. This is using my ring finger. So I've got my index and ring fingers on the guitar. From there, my middle finger goes to 2nd fret on the G. This gives us our D minor shape. If you look very carefully, you might notice some similarity between this and D major. In D major, the only difference is the high E string is 2nd fret, not 1st fret. If I slide this back finger forward, it gives me D major. Of course, the fingering is not quite the same, but it would be D major. If I swap the back two, I end up with the same D major shape that most people use. You can think of this chord as D major with what I call the old swap and slide. So from here, the back two fingers swap and that index finger slides. I'll show you again. From D major, swap the back two and slide the index down. That gives us D minor. With the D minor chord, just like the D major, we only want the D string and downward. So I have a few options. I can play from the D string down, which doesn't work out great in practice. A better alternative is to use my thumb to touch that low E string. And sometimes we might hit that A string. That is okay because there's not a whole lot we can do about it. With all strumming, remember that it's very much an approximation of what we want. So we don't need to get exactly the right strings every single time. In fact, we rarely do that. We roughly strum in the correct location and we might hit one or two either side. And usually that works out okay. This chord comes from step 2 of the Ultimate Guitar Method, for which you can find some links to below in the notes, as well as a downloadable PDF for this chord. Thanks for watching, guys, and until next time, keep shredding.